Ireland once had abundance of thatched vernacular buildings. The Normans arrived in Ireland over 800 years ago and introduced this style of house to Ireland. Many have fallen into neglect and lie derelict. This is a shame as they provide a very real link to Ireland's past heritage. However, there are people who still make an effort to preserve and maintain these ancient structures. From this viewpoint, we can see how the house is set into the land. The reason for this is to provide shelter for its occupants. Notice how the gable is windowless. This gable faces into the prevailing wind. The wall and hedgerow in the yard provided further shelter as well as farming practicality. Note the original wrought iron gates and the original pier constructed using barrel method. We can see from the corner of the wall and also in the window reveal that the wall is not straight. This is because the wall is constructed in a taper manner, being far wider at the bottom than it is the top. This provided strength and stability in the wall. Square headed openings with 1/1 sliding sash windows make up the form of this dwelling. The windows are set deeply in the reveals, which enhances the characteristics of the house. Not part of the original construction, this porch was an addition, built about 70 years ago. The door is but 6 foot tall, which adds to the character of the house. The porch was constructed because the door had to be moved from the front to the back of the house, due to the new road construction so close to the house at the time. The roof has a steep pitched, hipped, scalloped, thatched roof. The thatched roof is in fabulous condition as a real feature of this house. Wires run just below the ridge from gable to gable to protect in times of storm. Here we see the extra thatch protected against excess water moving off the chimney. It is held in place using black celly legging and doubles as an attractive feature. They are held in position using roofing staples called speedogues or scallops. Note the holes in the chimney. These were fitted to provide extra draw for the chimney, which was disturbed when the door was moved from the front to the back of the house. Thatching is a dying trade. Between the lack of thatchers, the maintenance involved, as well as costs, few new houses are thatched. The secret to good thatching is to drive the scallops in well below the thatch so as not to be exposed to the weather. The reed used in this area is harvested from the Shannon estuary. It is important to cut it at the very bottom where it is strongest. The straw must be well wetted down before use. Dry straw can become very loose quickly. Like slating, you thatch from the eave towards the ridge. Backfilling ensures the air gap under the reed is maintained when the reed is driven back. If the air gap is not maintained, the reed will rot. Rolls of reed are made which form the ridge support structure. Fit the ridge rolls, the last few rolls of reed are applied. The reed overshoots the ridge. The ridge is finished with straw which is flexible enough to be bent over the ridge. The eaves is trimmed at the end. Moss will grow on the side of the roof that is not exposed as much as the others due to obstructions or not facing. This means the roof is not drying out as much as it should because it is not getting enough sunlight. The traditional open hearth fireplace had a dual function of heating the house and cooking for the family and animals, turf and wood providing fuel. The pots or skillets hung on the iron crane dangling over the flame. The crane rotated away from the flame to access the skillet. Here we see how open the red brick chimney construction really was. We can just imagine the heat loss. We have come to the end of this presentation of an example of our built heritage. It is important to understand and appreciate its significance and its contribution to our society. I hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for watching.
spinning round.